entering the ring wearing black and red trunks and hailing from Huntington, New York. She weighed in at 142 and 1/4 pounds with a fine record of 14 wins, 1 loss, and 3 draws. She has 3 wins coming by way of knockout. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome the IWBF champion, introducing Kathy the Wildcat Collins. And presenting her opponent across the ring on my right, fighting out of the red corner, this 10-round attraction, entering the ring wearing her traditional pink trunks with white trim, fighting out of Orlando, Florida, by way of West Virginia, she weighed in at 144 pounds. With an outstanding record of 42 wins, 2 losses, and 2 draws, she has 31 big wins coming by way of knockout. Ladies and gentlemen, here is the WBA and WBC Women's Champion, known as the Coal Miner's Daughter, introducing Christy Martin. Once again, Steve Smoker, our referee in charge.
You were given your instructions at the way in which to obey my commands at all times, respect the bone, above all, protect yourself. This is a good shot right here. Christy, ladies, touch him up. Touch him up. Very good.
Christy Martin has been in a lot of wars. This is her 47th professional fight. Her husband and trainer, Jim Martin, took me aside after our fighter meetings yesterday and said, I'm very concerned about this fight.
Husband and trainer is a common phrase in women's boxing. Kathy Collins is also married to her trainer. His name is Dom Marino. And as we watch the fight, we're joined not only by two-time heavyweight champion Big George Foreman, TVKO boxing expert, but also by unbeaten woman boxing star Lucia Riker, who would love to fight the winner. Lucia, not nearly as well known among the general public as is Christy Martin, but regarded by a lot of ringside experts as the best woman fighter in the world. Lucia, how well do you know these two fighters, and what do you expect from the fight?
Well, I know Kathy Collins, her amateur career, and I know she really paid her dues climbing up to becoming a professional. I don't think she has as much experience as Christy, and I think that'll be a setback in this fight.
Indeed, Christy, with 46 professional fights, an unparalleled record among women boxers, she's had a lot of opportunities.
Jim, for the first time, I feel like the good old boys is going down the drain. We got help for a change.
Well, Christy Martin's purse, $250,000, sufficient to indicate the level of public esteem to which women's boxing, at least in her instance, has risen. There's a good straight right hand by Martin. So far, both women working conventionally behind the jab, and now Christy lands another solid right hand. But Collins comes in and smashes Martin with a left hook of her own. Is this a more conservative Christy Martin than we normally see, Lucia?
No, not at all. I think she takes her time to set it up and to clock her with that right hand.
So the first 2-minute round comes to a close, a scheduled 10, and we go to the corners.
Perfect. Oh, yeah. She might bounce around like that, all of a sudden they jump in, try to get 6 punches off.
Right.
Lucia, very quickly while they go through the corner routine here, you yourself have not had a professional prize fight since August of 1999.
That's right.
I'm sure you still regard yourself as active as ever, right?
I'm always active in the gym. I mean, I shot a movie last year for 5 months in Montreal, which was really challenging physically, but more mentally, which got me even more ready for this big fight that I'm looking at, because it's all mental. Physically, for me, it's just a piece of cake. I've been fit my whole life since I was 15, so training is easy for me.
You'd like to fight the winner of this fight, right?
I'd like to fight Christy.
You'd like to fight Christy. And how confident are you of getting a shot at it?
We're pretty close. We've been talking to King, and we got very close to a deal. Probably we're looking at December.
A fight Long time in the making, but greatly to be hoped for. Christy Martin against Lucia Riker. Of course, step one, Martin needs to get past Kathy Collins, the woman who's in front of her here. In round one, by CompuBox numbers, Martin 13 out of 42, Collins 6 out of 35. George, what do you see so far?
Well, I see Collins throwing a right hand occasionally, and that can pay a toll if this fight continues on for three or four rounds. The big punches not like to get hit a lot, especially around the chest and the side. What do you think about that? Does it really take away from being hit in the chest by women?
It throws on the breast, you mean. On the breast, you don't really feel. On the chest, it can throw you off balance. But the breast, I don't think, it never really bothered me.
Okay. I've always wanted to ask that question.
I talked to a doctor about that, actually, because they're doing some research on breast protection. So it's really interesting that I don't have any background on whether it is dangerous for women to get hit in the breasts or not.
Okay, good news.
Christy Martin still throwing 1-2 combinations. Kathy Collins' most effective punch has been the left hook. She's landed it upstairs a couple of times when Martin dropped her right.
The last time that Christy Martin fought, she was extended. And I think she's been all through conservative this time to make sure that she has something if this fight continues on for a few rounds, I think.
I think she's going to think it's going to go to distance, so she doesn't want to get tired.
Both women working the jab in this round. Christy Martin got there first with the right hand, a little short with the left hook coming back. Crowd getting into the fight. Already in the early undercard bouts, they've shown themselves to be a tremendously lively crowd. There's a big right hand by Christy Martin, and round two comes to a close.
Relax, 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 stay relaxed. Be alert on defense, Kat, all right? Stay in a distance, and then when she comes in, you go first, all right? 3-3, quick 3-3, all right? Relax, you're doing all right. You're doing the rest of the body. Okay. Deep breath, deep breath, deep breath. Oh, you got to throw more combination, all right, Kat?
One kilogram. She got right eyes all shot red.
Left eye.
Get your distance, get your distance. You bet you have in her face, power jabs. Make them quick though.
Okay. Kathy Collins says that one of her greatest assets is a great Irish jaw. And Christy Martin tested that jaw a couple of times in this round.
Kathy Collins says to us that in 18 prize fights, she has not been knocked down. Jabs through the second round, Martin landing hers with much greater consistency, 15 out of 47. Collins only 3 out of 40. She's been short with the jab most of the way.
I would like to see Kathy to commit to her punches more.
I mean, she takes them out, bring them back.
She's waiting too long. She's letting Christy make the fight.
Okay.
She should start sooner. Be more aggressive. Commit to the right hand.
If she had the same strength in her shoulders as Christy Martin, there's no need in her being reluctant.
One thing that Collins has done in this fight, more than you usually see in women's prize fighting, is she's throwing more body punches.
She is doing a good job of throwing body punches.
Nobody is better schooled as a women boxer as Christy Martin, as her experience has shown.
She has doubled the record, 3.5 times the record that Kathy has. So I think it's very courageous of Kathy to take this fight.
Well, Kathy said she's been boxing 7 years to get to this moment, training her sights on the possibility of having this fight. And I think since she waited so long, Lucia, she ought to get farther inside and try to rough Christy up more.
Well, you can't underestimate the punches of Christy, because Christy does commit. And what also happens when you're a female fighter and you're good, a lot of people around you hype you. They're like, you can do it, but they don't see that Christy has 3 times the experience that Kathy has.
Kathy Collins has landed 3 or 4 very hard punches in the last 30 seconds.
Right hand.
Big right hand.
But Martin looking not too much the worse for wear as they go back to the corners again.
Now, Lucia, we want to hear your version of the altercation that you had with Christy Martin. She says you sucker punched her and you wound up on the floor. What happened?
Hard right hand by Collins. Go ahead, Lucia.
I went to see a public training and I should never have been there because the moment she saw me, she started screaming at me. And the moment she shoved me, I had a reflex with a left hook. After that, she jumped me, ran me into a machine, and then I got jumped by 10 of her bodyguards when we were rolling on the floor. It was really like the Midwest.
This was a gym in Los Angeles, right?
Yes.
All right, Harold Letterman, how do you have it scored 3-3?
Okay, Jim, I got a 3-0, 30-27, Christy Martin. Jim, I'm just impressed by Christy's flat-footed punching. In other words, she's landing at a power shots. Kathy Collins doing too much running, not getting much power, because she's backing up. So far, Christy Martin 3-0 based on the fact that she's landing more power shots.
I gave the last round to Kathy Collins.
Because of those good right hands.
Yeah, she landed 3 or 4 real hard punches in the last 30 seconds of that round.
Lucia Riker, the 2-minute time limit for women's rounds, reminds me that before 1984, the Track and Field Federation didn't think that women could complete a marathon. Would you rather be fighting 3-minute rounds just like the men do?
I think the new generation should get ready for the 3 rounds. Because women's boxing is so new, we still get accustomed to it, and the longer the rounds, the more sluggish the fights will look. So to keep the pace up, I think the 2 minutes are good.
Could you fight 3-minute rounds?
Sure, I would.
All right, as round 4 winds down here between Christy Martin and Kathy Collins, we're going to bid farewell with a big thank you to superstar Lucia Riker, who favored us with her commentary here for the first 4 rounds. Lucia, best of luck.
Thank you so
much. I hope
much.
You get a chance to fight the winner.
Me too. Thanks. Thanks for having
All
me, George.
The best.
And thanks for
Go get him, champ. See you next time.
Ooh,
hard left hook by Christy Martin after a sizzling left hook by Collins to end the round. And coming up next, you'll see welterweights Vernon Forrest and Raul Frank. Forrest and Frank, who had a no contest last August, have been preparing for a year to fight against each other. They hope to finally get it done tonight.
Rhythm now, all right? You can start counter punching. When you go first, you look good. She look bad. That's what you gotta do. Same piece, that's you go. All right, Kat? You're doing good.
Your defense is so
Here's
fucking
your water.
Beautiful. You are lovely. You are the best. You are the best. Right. You keep doing it. You don't let up.
And combination.
All right. Drag the body.
Mr. Robes, she sees usually slide off this way.
Drag the body.
Look for the chin. Look for the chin. Don't just throw. Look for the chin.
Round 5 of a scheduled 10. Christy Martin, coal miner's daughter, in the pink trunks and singlets. And in the red and black outfit, that's Kathy Collins. Harold Letterman's card visible to you at this point. Power punches landed through round 4. Christy Martin, according to CompuBox numbers, has landed 40-20 for Kathy Collins. Collins has had some big right hand shots, and she was just a tiny bit short with another one right there.
You can't clown with Collins, evidently. Christy Martin is doing a good job of boxing tonight. Not only is she throwing power shots, but she's doing a double jab, triple jab, all of the things you need to do as a boxer.
I think this is the most complete performance I've seen from Christy Martin.
Yeah, she's not charging in like the raging bull or raging cow.
Raging cow. I can't wait to
They
see
will
that.
Get you, too. I live on a ranch and the cows will attack out.
Raging cow. I love it.
Collins has the best right hand tonight. She's been going right on top. Ooh, that body
right
shot.
Right to the body by Martin. Two more body shots, a left hook. Sensational rally right there by Christy Martin.
Off her neck, workout, that's it.
Now Collins going to the body as she pins Christy against the ropes. Very physical fight.
Been real effective with those right overhand right Collins has. Now she needs to continue that. Something is working. Don't worry about going to the body. Keep doing what you're doing.
Lead right hand from Martin. Hitting to the left hook to the body. Good stuff. And round five.
Oh, she can do it. No more. It's off.
It's off for this guy.
It's off. Quit.
How you feel?
Good. Yeah. It's off for this guy. Breathe deep. Breathe deep.
Never forget your jab. Work in behind that jab. Everything's coming off good. The straight right hand's coming off good. I want a right hand on that chin.
Let me have your face.
That's what his spin right there.
Let me have your face.
Yeah, last touch, beautiful spin. That's what he stay low. Perfect ground.
Good deep ground. Bend your knees when you.
Yes, you want it.
Good, Doc. Give
you got to work hard. Extra effort. Extra combination.
This is
extra
where you show you want it.
Here we see Kathy Martin, who is just such a good schooled. A well-schooled fighter, the right intuitions, comes back with combination punches. I've watched her work in the gym, and you don't see many fighters of any gender work as hard or as proficiently at her craft. Not as strong as men, obviously, but she knows how to fight.
Body punching that Christy Martin is doing probably because going to be our salvation if this fight continues for a few rounds. It's going to take all of the energy out of them. This.
Collins.
Martin ducking and slipping inside and then missing with the big right hand.
When you're fighting a puncher, you want to make sure certain that a puncher throw away a lot of those energies. Make them miss. Make them throw that energy away. Make them miss.
Kathy Collins has been effective at that in this round, although in the last round, as we saw by CompuBox numbers, Martin landed more than half her punches.
You've got to hit her, move out of the way, hit her, move out of the way, until make her try to hit you back.
Here with us, Lucia Riker said that she thought Martin believed the fight was going to go the distance and was pacing herself for that assignment. Now they complete the sixth of a scheduled 10 rounds. Meanwhile, about an hour ago, Felix Trinidad pulled into Madison Square Garden. The crowd has been chanting his name relentlessly during the early fights. Tito not yet in the arena. When thousands here began chanting, Tito, Tito, Tito. Rest assured, you'll hear the crescendo during the big fight later on. Here is middleweight titleist William Joppy, whose crown will be on the line tonight in this second of the three fights which make up the middleweight world championship unification series.
Put your head in your chest. Use those strong legs that God bless you with.
3-3 and 50-50, all right, Kat? Don't forget the 8-8. There you go.
You hear him?
You hear him?
Good.
You heard it.
All right. Kathy Kathy Collins' left eye beginning to swell, as you saw in that shot in round six. By CompuBox estimation, Collins had a 10-9 edge in power punches connected, one of her better rounds so far.
Her corner is urging her basically to go to war, to get inside on Christy Martin, because the fight is slipping away.
Harold, how do you have it through six?
Okay, Jim, I got it 6-0, 60-54, Christy Martin. You know, Jim, Kathy Collins is throwing out light left jab, moving in and out, but really not doing much damage. She just, when she lays a shot, she runs away. Christy Martin, on the other hand, flat-footed, laid the most of the power shots. So far, I think she's gotten the best of them virtually all the rounds.
Collins landed a right hand.
And a hook also. Made Christy Martin smile a little bit. We know what that means.
Yeah, we saw Lennox Lewis grinning like that down in Johannesburg on the first Rockman right hand. Now 20 seconds before the second one iced him. Martin came back with a barrage of body shots after taking the right hand from Kathy Collins. Now Christy goes back upstairs.
Collins is getting a little confident now, putting a little power, a little body into those hooks.
Even though Harold Letterman had Christy Martin winning each of the first six rounds, Kathy Collins has been effective from time to time with the right hand. Larry Merchant, let's take a look at a package of Kathy Collins' right hands.
There you see in close the right hand. She's not a big puncher. Very few women are big punchers when they're fighting well-conditioned opponents, but she's getting the right hand in cleanly. Kathy Martin is an aggressive fighter.
Christy Martin.
Christy Martin. Thank you, Jim. And she is open for the right hand when she comes in.
Here's your orange.
Look at her, Christy.
Look at the way she's sitting. Wow, she's very nice.
CompuBox numbers in round seven show both fighters landing 13 power shots. Martin 13 out of 26. Collins 13 out of 28.
In Martin's corner, they're saying that Kathy Collins was crying in her corner.
Sometimes that's the best thing for a fighter to do is to cry.
There's no crying in boxing, George.
Oh, yes, you better cry sometimes. It's easier to cry and say, I got to get them, than to say, I'll quit.
Round seven was the first one that Harold Letterman has given to Kathy Collins. Collins chopping away with the right hand here as round eight progresses. Bout is scheduled for 10 rounds. Christy Martin has never had a knockout past the seventh.
There goes the right hand. See the tears? It'll make you fight. Sometimes you cry because you can't do anything else. You know you're going to continue to fight, although you're being hurt.
In golf, you can often tell how good a player is just by the way he sets up over the ball. Kathy Collins has a great setup. She looks like a pro when she gets into her stance and gets ready to fire the jabs.
Boy, she's going to the body with left hooks. Kathy goes to the body real good. Now there's a right hand.
Both fighters seem to be tiring a bit as we come to the closing stages of round eight and the tempo slows.
Another right hand by Collins.
Kathy Collins able to land her right hand pretty frequently.
Oh, the combination.
And draw blood. Kathy Martin.
Christy Martin.
Christy Martin is bleeding from the nose. not an uncommon sight when she fights.
Both women gasping for breath a little bit as round eight is completed. Two more rounds to go.
On the inside.
Here's your water. You almost are. Good, go tense, busy, all right?
We always finish strong.
Simple.
A little pressure, honey.
Keep your chin down, punch that clock.
I'll repeat, keep those hands up.
Christy Martin's bloody nose may have been caused by the head first, followed by a straight left hand.
Round 9 out of 10. Kathy Collins in the red and black, Christy Martin in pink.
Both fighters are in extremely good condition.
Aren't they, though?
Still throwing with the same power they had in the first couple of rounds.
And still with the head movement, the upper body feints, the footwork. They're conditioned to go.
That was that right hand.
And Christy Martin again grinning after taking a hard right hand shot. Kathy Collins may wind up wishing this were a 12-round fight.
There's that excellent left jab by Christy Martin again. Starts the round off with a good left jab and finish it up midways and at the end. Christy Martin steps in with that hard left jab. This time, Collins caught her with a counter right hand on top of that jab.
Pete, don't punch. Step out, step out.
Martin winging shots from both sides. Some of them blocked, some of them getting through to the rib cage. Now Collins comes forward, firing upstairs. Martin grinning again, trying to duck and feint.
Right hand again by Collins. Whenever she wants, she can dig up a good right hand.
Eighth round.
Breathe through your mouth.
Breathe
through your mouth.
You need this round, okay?
Breathe through your mouth.
Yeah, I mean, I'm on the round.
Come on, fine, you can have this again, all right?
Yeah.
Keep her at a distance, you go first. Keep her at a distance, you go first, all right? 50-50, 3-3, all right? 8-8, you go.
She's looking out there on my right hand, so it's the same thing.
Last one.
What do you got to score, Miguel?
Last one.
You got it.
You heard it, Kathy. Last one.
You don't stop till
last
you
one. All right?
Take it, baby.
There is either an abrasion or a slight cut over the left eye of Kathy Collins. This has been a fiercely contested, well-fought women's fight.
By CompuBox numbers in round 9, Collins had a 12-5 edge in Power Connects. Martin landed her jab more frequently. Harold, how do you have it going to the last round?
Okay, Jim, I got an 88-83, 7 rounds to 2, Christy Martin. Jim, as I see this fight, Kathy just didn't stand the fight enough. I mean, you know, she'd stick out that light left jab and move. If she'd stand there and throw that right hand, a good left hook a little more, maybe she had a chance of out-banging Christy. But basically, what she did, she got nailed by that Christy Martin overhand right and that vicious Christy Martin left hook. Christy's a terrible hard puncher. Flat-footed, always a good position to throw a power punch, and she's been landing him and winning the fight.
I have it 6 rounds to 3.
Christy Martin can also take a good punch.
Yeah, because the biggest punch of this round was a hard left hook by Kathy Collins.
She's been a harder puncher throughout the fight. Christy Martin's just turned the other cheek.
Get out, get out, turn around, turn around. Hands up, ladies. Don't punch.
Well, Larry, I agree with you. The great step forward we've seen tonight here for women's boxing
is the
body punches thrown on both sides.
Well, they're becoming more sophisticated fighters over time. And hopefully we'll see Christy fight. We'll see a Riker someday. She talks about fighting Muhammad Ali's daughter.
Layla,
because she's better known, talks about fighting Mia St. John because she's been promoted a great deal, but says she wants to hang the gloves up by the end of the year and start having a family.
And the bout ended with Collins driving Martin into the ropes, and as the bell sounded, Christy just threw her off, as if to say, well, I've had enough of you. We'll see in a moment what the official decision brings.
Nice job, baby. Nice job, baby.
Final copy box numbers. A numerical profile of the fight that you just saw. Martin landing 174 out of 462. Collins 105 of 370 by copy box numbers. So overall, Martin throwing more, landing more, and landing at a higher connect percentage that usually translates to victory. Jabs, and in the closing rounds, the jab was Christie's best weapon as Collins began to get it cranked up with power punches. 23 out of 156 is not good, and it indicates that maybe Collins should have tried to get a little closer during the bout. You heard Christy Martin's one critical comment for herself. I never picked it up the way I should have. Looking back, she must feel as though she could have put more pressure on in the late rounds. Nice people, Christy and her husband. Fun people to talk to. Same with Kathy and her group. And now let's go to ring announcer Jimmy Lennon Jr. and hear who won the fight.
Ladies and gentlemen, after 10 rounds of action, we go to the scorecards with a majority decision. Here are the score totals. Judge at ringside, Frank Lombardi, scores at 95 to 95, even a draw. Overruled by judges, Tom Kazmarek, scores at 97 to 93. Larry Hazard Jr. sees it 98 to 92 in favor of the winner, the coal miner's daughter, Christy Martin.
Some of the crowd not in agreement with the decision.